All right. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, cheetahs. So, guess what? It's our last Monday morning assembly for the school year, right? So today is Monday, June 6th, and we are going to get started with our very last Monday morning assembly for the 2021-2022 school year. So it is our last one, our last time together on Zoom for this school year. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Again, it's Monday, June 6th, and I don't know about you guys, but I'm excited. It's the last week of school. All right, so as always, we are going to start with our Pledge of Allegiance. Okay, right hand over your heart, please. And read along with me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now in Spanish, for our dual language program, lea conmigo, por favor, mano derecha sobre su corazón. Yo prometo lealtad a la bandera de los Estados Unidos de América y a la república que representa una nación bajo Dios, indivisible, con libertad y justicia para todos. All right, everybody, let's keep going here. All right, so a reminder, once again, this is the last week of school. So, you know, we have standing reminders, right? So one of our standing reminders is our positive student behavioral expectations. So rule number one, as always, is to follow school and classroom rules. Rule number two is to solve conflicts without physical or verbal violence. Rule number three is to keep our school clean or help us keep our school clean. Number four is to report any bullying, harassment, or hate-motivated incidents. Number five is to display good sportsmanship on the playground. And rule number six is to always be on time and be ready to learn. All right. So also in regards to, you know, following school rules and such, right? Also being safe, being respectful, and being responsible on campus. So be responsible, be safe, be respectful on the yard, in the restroom, and all over, pretty much on campus, right? So all areas of our school. And a reminder that this week we are collecting devices, okay? So today, I believe second and third graders are returning their devices, right? Beginning at about 10 a.m. Before you return your device, please make sure that you cleaned it up, right? That you remove any stickers. If you put any stickers on there, make sure that you take those off. Make sure, again, that it's clean when you return it. And make sure that you return your device, obviously. Any chargers. If it's an iPad, you should return it with the cord and the charger brick, right? And also, if you have a... if you have a hotspot that you borrowed from us, that needs to come back as well. Okay, so not just devices, but also accessories like the hotspot, if you have one, if you happen to have one. Okay, all right. And since it is the last week of school, I also want to remind everyone that we are celebrating our fifth graders this week. They are culminating, right? Which means they're finishing up elementary school, and they'll be moving on to their respective middle school, right? Whether it's John Lathy, John Burroughs, or any of the other schools in our area, or maybe even schools out of the district. So they will be moving on to middle school, and that's a huge accomplishment, right? So, you know, again, we're celebrating our fifth graders this week. Okay, we're also celebrating additional reclassifying students. So we have more. We're up to quite a few reclassified students this year. We're, I believe, surpassed the 30s, right, in terms of our numbers of reclassified students. So anyway, we're celebrating today Stephanie Hernandez-Sarat in Mr. Pulisic's class, Jesus Renteria in Ms. Hernandez's class, Shailene Villasaldo in Ms. Chan's class as well. Okay, so Big round of applause for our reclassifying students. Great job, guys. That's another huge accomplishment. And Ms. Hodge, did you want to say any words in regards to reclassification?
Just I'm so very proud of all of our 32 kiddos so far that have reclassified, and I'm hopeful that we're going to have many more. That means that they have passed their LPAC, they have passed their DIBLs, and they have passed their grades. So great job to all 32 of our kids so far, and three from just last week.
Yep. Great job, everyone. And thank you, Ms. Orge, for supporting with that. All right. And a reminder, this is to everyone, right? Last day of school this school year, right, is this Friday, June 10th. So this is the last day of the school year, Friday, June 10th. So make sure, fifth graders, that I know culmination is on Thursday, but, right, please be here on Friday, June 10th. So a reminder of that. Okay, and now we have a quick video. So with the last day of school year coming up, you know, I wanted to show maybe a quick video on summer activities. What are some things that you're planning on doing during the summer, right? If you're, you know, going to summer camp, or you're joining one of LAUSD's summer programs, whether it's the one that we are going to host here with Mr. Sam, right? Or if it's another program, right? So let's go ahead and watch this quick video on summer activities. No! It's a silly little song that I like, by the way. That's a silly little video, but, and I did see some of our fifth graders roll their eyes for a minute, but, you know, it's cute. And Singing Walrus, that's like one of my kids and I, that's one of our favorite little artists. All right. So anyway, hope you enjoyed the song. It was cute. It had some nice high frequency words in there. So, all right. And then, you know, just a reminder, right, to everybody, the summer programs that are happening, right? So if you go on to Summer of Learning, the catalog, the summer school program catalog for LAUSD, you know, you can find some activities on there, but also, you know, some of the different programs that we have. So make sure that you let your parents know about this, right? They actually should know by now, but in case not, you know, go on there. They also have, like I said, they have other ideas for activities that you can do that are absolutely free, right, in our city, especially in LA. There's so much going on, and there's a lot of free activities that you actually have access to. Or if it's not free, it's relatively really cheap. So like you can go to the Natural History Museum, for example, you know, and I believe the entrance is only about $8. You know, so it's relatively cheap. There's tons of museums in the city, parks. So anyway, take advantage of that this summer, you know, get out and you know, learn some of the cultural things that are out there for you to do. All right. And then another idea in terms of summer, right? Another activity is, don't forget, you all have access to Renaissance Mayan, right? So don't forget about that. You can go on Mayan and you can read thousands of books. They're all there for you waiting, right? So all you need to do is open up that new laptop that you got from the district, go on Renaissance Mayan and catch up on your reading, right? Pick some books to read over the summer. All right. So we're getting into our shout outs. This past week, we had fabulous performances from our fourth grade classes, right? So a big shout out, big bravacado to Ms. Morales for coordinating and obviously volunteering her time and talent, right, to our students and our school. Ms. Aguilera's class also participated, Ms. Morales's class, Ms. Gonzalez's class, Ms. Tappy, and Treviño's classes. Wonderful performances from them. Thank you all for putting on just a great show for us last week, Friday. All right, and then we're moving on to our bucket fillers for the week. Our first bucket filler winner is Alejandro in Ms. Brosi's class. Then we have Ariel Mazariegos in Ms. Prados' class. We also have Brianna in Ms. Chan's class, Laura Rodriguez in Ms. Cam's class, Dylan Barillas with Mr. Kwan. That should say Allison. Sorry about that. My apologies. Allison Garcia in Ms. Treviño's class, Israel Castro in Ms. Chin's class, Darwin in Ms. Frady's class, Amy Cantera in Ms. Mendoza Gonzalez's class, Henderson Gomez in Ms. Aguilera's class, Cynthia Garcia in Mr. Pulisic's class, and Jacqueline in Mr. Perez's class. Round of applause for all of our bucket filler winners. Great job, guys. Keep earning those bucket fillers. And we're finally at our last joke of the week for the school year. All right, so here's our last joke of the week. It better be a good one, huh? All right, so why did the teacher throw her watch out the window? Let's see. Because she wanted to see time fly. All right, well, teachers, you don't have to see time fly anymore because it has flown. We're at the last week of school. So that's some consolation to this terrible joke. All right, everybody. I hope you enjoyed our last Monday morning assembly for the school year. It was a pleasure to be with you all. To our fifth graders, we love you. We're going to miss you. Good luck in middle school and, you know, going forward, right? But don't forget, you're always going to be a cheetah. Right. So you're always a cheetah and this is always your home. So we're going to miss you all and we love you all. And I love everybody. So have a great rest of your week and an even better summer vacation. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
So bring your good times and your laughter too. We gon' celebrate your party with you. Come on now.